Welcome back to Mama Thando's isiZulu classroom, where learning isiZulu is fun. IsiZulu simnandi. Ngingumama uThando. Lo ukhomba. Wena ungubani? Ngiyajabula ukukwazi. Mngani, let's sing the Sawubona song and greet all our friends around the world. Sawubona, sawubona, unjani mngani? Sondela hlala phansi, sifunde mngani. Mngani, unjani? Well, hold that thought. Let's sing imizwa yethu first. Imizwa yethu. Mina nginemizwa, wena unemizwa, yena unemizwa, bona banemizwa, sonke sinemizwa. Mina nginjani, ngabe ngiyaphila, ngabe ngidumele, ngabe ngikhathele, ngabe nginjani. Mina ngiyaphila, ngabe wena unjani, ngabe uyaphila, ngabe uyakula, ngabe ujabule. Wena uyaphila, yena unjani. Ngabe udangele, ngabe ukhathele, ngabe unene. Yena uyaphila, bona banjani. Ngabe bayaphila, ngabe bayakhala, ngabe bathokozile. Bona bayaphila, thina sinjani. Ngabe siyaphila, ngabe sineme, ngabe sijabule. Thina sijabule, thina sijabule. Okay, now you can answer the question. Unjani? Ngiyajabula ukuzwa lokho. So happy to hear that. Mina mngani, ngijabule. I am happy. Thank you.
Ngizwa imvula, wena awuzwa, Kapa kapa imbula, sengithiwe.
Yebo mngani, that's the sound of the rain. Imvula, the rain. Now mngani, moving on from rain. Mngani, I would like you to sing the days of the week with me, and then I would like you to answer a couple of questions for me. Now, let me put Khomba down. Khomba, hlala la phansi. Let me pull up my sleeves, my jersey. Now, mngani, this song, you can either stomp your feet, snap your fingers, clap your hands, chigiza, whatever you feel like doing, as long as you're having fun memorizing the days of the week and pronouncing them correctly. Let's start.
Isonto umsombuluko, lesibili ulwesithathu, lesine ulwesihlanu, kube umgqibelo. Izinsuku.
Wonderful, mngani. Now, mngani, tell me, looking at the days of the week, one of them is not spelled correctly. Which one is it? That is correct, Mngani. It says Umombulu. Umombulu. I can't even say it. That's supposed to be Umsombuluko. You are correct, Mngani. Great job. Now, looking at the days of the week here, Mngani. Let me move to the side. Looking at the days of the week, we need to answer these questions. I've already answered this one for you. That's the last time we saw each other was izolo, yesterday. And we said it was Wednesday. So, izolo bekulwesithathu. Yesterday was Wednesday. And we have that w before ulwesithathu. Because that's the one that helps us to say is or was Wednesday. Now, Mngani, I would like us to fill up the rest of these sentences, complete them. We now know what izolo was. So, what was kuthangi? Kuthangi beku. Yebo, Mngani, beku lwesibili. Let's put that on the board. And we know what day it was yesterday, then we should know what day it is today, right? Namhlanje ulwesine. Let's put it on the board. Okay, one more to go. Tomorrow, kusasa. Kusasa kuzobe. Yebo Mngani. Kusasa kuzobe kuLwesihlanu. Great work, Mngani, in answering those questions. Now, Mngani, I would like to know what the weather is like. So, let's ask that question. How do we say, what is the weather like? Linjani izulu namhlanje. Now, the word izulu is the one that is the weather. Linjani izulu namhlanje. Linjani, linjani izulu namhlanje. Liyabanda, liyashisa. Linjani namhlanje. Linjani izulu. Mngani, check through your window and come back and tell me what the weather is like. Don't worry, I'll be right here, drinking water. How usubuyile Mngani? Linjani izulu namhlanje? Oh, ngiyabonga ukungazisa. Letting me know. Now, I would like to know what the weather is like here where Mama Tando's isiZulu classroom is. To do that, we need to call the imaginary window. Let's call him together. Imaginary window! Woza! Ngiyabonga. Sawubona imaginary window. Ngicela ukubona imnyango. See what you wait here? So exciting! I don't know why the world makes it even more cold, but at least my trees and my flowers and my grass are getting watered. Isn't that just nice? Yeah. Imaginary window, ngiyabonga. Hamba kahle. Now, Mngani. Outside, it is raining and it's also cold. How do we say that in isiZulu to say, today the weather is rainy and cold. Very good, Mngani. We must remember to use that word futhi between those two. Liyanetha, futhi, liyabanda. Now, Mngani, read this after me. Namhlanje izulu, liyanetha, futhi, liyabanda. Very, very good, Mngani. Mngani, liyabanda, it is cold. Mina, ngiyagodola, I am feeling cold. Ngiyagodola. Repeat that after me. Ngiyagodola. Very good, Mngani. So we say a person is feeling cold. Godola. That's the verb. But the weather itself is cold. Banda. Now, Mngani, let's check if Amahle is dressed just right for today's weather. Let's call her. Amahle, woza. Sawubona, Amahle.
Yebo, sawubona, Mama Thando.
Ugqokeni namhlanje?
Ngigqoke ibhantshi, ngigqoke ibhulukwe, ngigqoke amasokisi, ngigqoke amabhuzu.
Oh, siyabonga ukusazisa, Amahle. Mngani, Amahle has told us what she is wearing. But now I would like us to describe those things. So we will say a white jacket, black trousers, red socks, black boots, all in isiZulu. Now, let's start. A white jacket. Then, to do this exercise, you can go ahead and pause the video right here where you can see all these words and write them down in isiZulu. And also then say them out loud, read them out loud in isiZulu. And then come right back to me. Now, Mngani, what did you say here for a white jacket? Ibhantshi elimhlophe. Very good. Black trousers. Ibhulukwe elimnyama. Red socks. Amasokisi abomvu. Black boots. Amabhuzu amnyama. Very, very, very good, Mngani. Great job. Now, Mngani, let us help Amahle usala. Usunga hamba manje. Hamba kahle Amahle. I didn't realize Amahle was still here. Now, Mngani, let's move on to the sound of the week. The sound of the week is made by these two letters, GC, and it is th, th, th. It's a sound that we make by pushing our tongue towards the front of our mouth, and then the tongue will show just a little bit between your top teeth and your bottom teeth. And then, Mngani, your tongue is stiff. It's pressing against the teeth. And then you pull it and drop it. quickly, like that. Now, like this. So, you must pull it and drop it quickly. Pull it and drop it. Like this, Mgan. Now, let's learn two words with this sound. You are also going to see the sound of the letter W. W, w, w. Right after the G sound. Gcwalisa. 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 That is to fill up. So if you are at the petrol station or the gas station, you say, Gcwalisa u petrol. Gcwalisa u diesel. Fill up the petrol or fill up the diesel. And then also, if you are in a place where you have to do it yourself, how boring, then you will say, Ngigcwalisa u petrol. I'm filling up the petrol. Ngigcwalisa u diesel. I'm filling up the diesel. Well, we are still very far from driving, aren't we? But one day we will say that. Now, gcwalisa, when you're filling up your cup with water, gcwalisa. Now, repeat this word after me, Mngani. Gcwalisa. Good job. And then another one, which is really like it, is gcwala, gcwala. Gcwala, which is to be full. So if a room is full of people or whatever, then gcwala is what we mean. Gcwala, to be full. Not to be full of food. So if you've had enough food, not that. So we could be talking about a bag, for example, and we are saying it's full. That kind of thing. Gcwala. Repeat that after me, Mngani. Gcwala. Very, very good, Mngani. Now, moving on from that to the number one that we've been working on this week. The number one is kunye. But when we count objects in isiZulu, we don't use the root of the number one. So we don't say nye. We use dwa. Now, this dwa has these unique prefixes. You don't see them anywhere else. Just when you're counting things and saying one of this and one of that. We saw that with words that are people, like umuntu, umngani, umfana, umfundi. When it's a person, we say oyedwa. The prefix is oye, like this. Umfundi oyedwa, one student. We also saw that when the word also starts with and umu, but it's not a person, like a home, a ship, a leg, a finger. So umuzi, umkumbi, umlenze, umunwe. They all start with or umu, but the prefix of the adjective dwa is different. It is owo, owo dwa, umunwe, owo dwa, umuzi, owo dwa. Then we also learned that the prefix is different for words that start with I or ili. Like, for example, ilihlo, one eye, ilihlo. We would then say elilo and then dwa. So like this, ilihlo, elilo, dwa, one eye. And then, again, we are continuing with this. For words that start with is or isi, we will say et si so, and then toi. Like this. Isanda, a hand. Isanda, esi so toi. One hand. Now let's have a look at these pictures, Mngani. Oh, a tree. One tree. That looks like my tree. Now, let's say one tree. Isihlahla esisodwa. Good job, Mngani. Oh, a chair. Isihlalo. Isihlalo esisodwa. Good job, Mngani. Now we have a t-shirt. How do we say one t-shirt? Very good, Mngani. Isikipa esisodwa. Shoe. One shoe. Isikatulo esisodwa. Isikatulo esisodwa. Very, very good, Mngani. That was great. Now, Mngani, the word for today is ubaba, ubaba, dad, father, ubaba. Now, although the word ubaba is dad or a father, we also use this word as a way to respect someone who is much older than us. Other people will say sir, mister in other languages. In isiZulu, you can say mnumzane, that's mister. But you don't really hear that a lot, Mngani, mnumzane. What you will really hear the most is people saying baba. So if we say Mr. Keswa, we will then say Babu Keswa, Mr. Keswa. That's not saying Babu Keswa is your father. It's just a way of saying Mr. Keswa. And then we are talking about him, not to him. We will then say U Babu Keswa. Now, Mngani, let's say that together. Ubabu Keswa. Very good, Mngani. Now, that's the word for the day. The other words we have learned this week, ukhokho, a great grandparent, ugogo, a grandmother, umkhulu, a grandfather, and namhlanje, ubaba, a father or dad. But we also use the word to say Mr. instead of Mnumzane, which is Mr. Now, Mngani, let us move on to the number of the day. The number of the day is 23. 23. Now, I would like us to say 23 ngesiZulu. Remember, we use place value. I will give you a few seconds to just think about what it could be. Try and put it together by yourself first. Now, Mngani, here is the number 23 in isiZulu. Amashumi amabili nantathu. Amashumi amabili nantathu. 23. Repeat it after me, Mngani. Amashumi amabili nantathu. Wonderful, Mngani. Now, we have who That's a very busy shop. 23 customers. The word customer in isiZulu is umthengi. Umthengi. But now, mngani, think about this. The word starts with yeah? And it is a person. So, mngani, what will it be when it's plural? Customers. Yebo, mngani. The plural starts with aba. Abathengi. Abathengi. Customers. Now let's say 23 customers. We'll start with the word customers, abathengi, followed by the adjective. The adjective will start with its prefix here because abathengi, the prefix is aba. And then we have those two letters, ng. Then we say amashumi, amabili, nantathu. Say it after me again. Abathengi, abangamashumi, amabili, nantathu. Very, very good job, Mngani. Now, Mngani, we've had such an amazing day of learning. I am really so proud of you, Mngani. Before you go, I think we need to just move our bodies a little bit. Ngizokubona kusasa. Sala kahle mngani.